Hi, this is Dr. Z. This video will briefly describe the nervous system. By the end of this video, you should be able to describe the peripheral nervous system and its two subsystems, the somatic and autonomic nervous system. You will also be able to explain how the autonomic nervous system is further broken down into two subsystems, called the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. And lastly, you will also be able to briefly describe the central nervous system. So let's get started. Are you sitting down while watching this video, or are you working out and listening to this video? Either way, your amazing body is doing what it's doing thanks to the two main nervous systems, the peripheral nervous system and the central nervous system. Let's talk first about the peripheral nervous system. The word peripheral comes from the root word periphery or perimeter, meaning the outside or external part of something. Basically, the PNS, for short, is everything in your body except for your brain and your spinal cord. That's a whole lot of body. Because the peripheral nervous system is so large, it is separated into two parts. The first part is the somatic nervous system. Let's think of your arms and legs as the outside or external parts of your body. You can move them, right? Do you feel like dancing right now? If so, your somatic nervous system is at work because it is in charge of senses and movement. I like to remember this by having the S in somatic stand for senses and the M stand for movement. So the next time you feel like dancing, the somatic nervous system played a role in it. Now remember that the P and S is so large that it's separated into two parts. The second part is the autonomic nervous system. The word autonomic comes from the root word auto, meaning automatic. So what does automatic mean? Automatic means to do something on its own or involuntary. In the case of the autonomic nervous system, it regulates certain bodily processes without conscious control. For example, are you breathing right now? Did you even realize you were doing it until I asked? You were breathing automatically, right? Now, are you telling yourself to breathe right now? And now? Of course not. You're not having a panic attack and breathing heavily. But the reason why you're breathing automatically is because your autonomic nervous system is doing it for you. Now, what other bodily responses are automatic? Well, examples include blinking, your heart beating, and digestion. Can you imagine how tired we would be if we constantly had to tell our body to keep pumping our heart to live? It's exhausting just thinking about it. Now, because the autonomic nervous system has a lot of body processes to control automatically, it is further separated into two parts: the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. These two parts are separate, yet work together in unison. So, in its simplest form, the sympathetic nervous system is a fight or flight response. I like to remember this by having the S in sympathetic stand for survival. What are you going to do to survive? Often that means fighting for your life, the fight response, or running for your life, in the case of this video, of the flight response. The sympathetic nervous system automatically mobilizes our body for survival. Your heart starts racing, your breathing quickens, your muscles tense, your digestive system even shuts down. All this in preparation for either fight or flight. We need the sympathetic nervous system to keep us alive in dangerous or potentially dangerous situations. Once a dangerous situation is over, our body returns to normal, thanks to our parasympathetic nervous system. Your heartbeat slows down, your breathing relaxes, your muscles become less tense, and your digestion resumes normal functioning. The parasympathetic system can be considered our rest and digest response. The parasympathetic system is where we relax and perhaps eat some pie. This system is needed for balanced functioning in our body. It is not healthy for our bodies to be constantly in the sympathetic nervous system. Wow, After all that, there's more? Yes, yes there is. Recall that your body consists of two main nervous systems, the peripheral nervous system and the central nervous system. The central nervous system, or CNS for short, comes from the word central. The root word is center, which means the middle or most important part of an object. In this case, the most important part of a human being is the brain and the spinal cord. Without these two objects, we would not be alive. The spinal cord is an extension of the brain, as it connects to the brain at the base of the brain. The spinal cord serves as the information highway, where it transmits messages between the brain and the peripheral nervous system. Recall the last time you danced? Well, your brain sent a message to your peripheral nervous system to shake those hips. In summary, our body is composed of the peripheral and central nervous systems, and our body is equally amazing and beautiful. The GIFs used in this video are property of the TV show Psych and the Big Bang Theory. Thank you.